Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to set up and automate dynamic product ads for Facebook remarketing in 2019. Let's go. All right, so what are dynamic remarketing ads for Facebook? So they are ads that adjust what the prospect or customer sees based on their individual session on your website. So with the Facebook pixel, it's going to store every web page that they went on that site, especially product pages, and then it can dynamically remarket to them based on that, okay? It's stored in your Facebook pixel, and it delegates that all automatically, and it's a very high converting ad because it shows them 100% a unique experience for them, okay? So how do I set up dynamic remarketing? I'm gonna show you that now. So you need to have a catalog for your business manager. Okay, so we will set up a catalog for the business manager. There's two ways of doing this. One, the Facebook sales channel, or two, a free app called Flexify, a Shopify free app, okay? And both of these push your catalog to your store, okay? And you need to check that your catalog is also then bound to your actual pixel so that it can then conjoin it and make DPA ads, otherwise they're not going to spend. So there's two ways for us to get our catalog into the Facebook Business Manager. The easiest way that I recommend is your Facebook sales channel. Okay, so on your Shopify, you're gonna have sales channels and you can add as many of these as you like. If you add the Facebook one, okay, it's gonna show up here. All you then need to do is basically you just log into your Facebook account. It's gonna ask for authorization. You bind it to the relevant page. Okay, so you just bind it to dog lovers page, and then that page is connected to your business manager. So it knows that and it's going to push it straight to your business manager, okay? If the Facebook sales channel does not work for you, there is the option of Flexify. There are the rare times where the Facebook sales channel unfortunately does not work. So if that is the case, what you do is you use Flexify, which is a free app, and you copy this RSS feed, and we're gonna make a catalog within Facebook itself. So I'm gonna show you that now. So under your business manager, you go under catalogs. Okay, we go under catalogs once it loads. And we go create catalog, e-commerce, choose products. We wanna choose who owns this, me, and you can give it a relevant name. It really doesn't matter as long as you know what that is. We go view, go into product data sources, and you choose use data feeds. Okay, we go next, and basically we want to go start on a schedule, and you put your, just paste your feed in there. Don't worry about the username, password, leave it at daily, your currency, which should be USD, and start upload, and that's it. Then it's going to take 20 minutes, half an hour to an hour, just let it do its thing. It's going to upload the feed, and it'll do it every day. Hey everyone, hope you're enjoying today's tutorial on Facebook dynamic product ads for 2019. Don't forget to subscribe to my videos and hit that notification bell and comment down below, crush it, to go in the chance to win one of two coaching calls for 15 minutes with myself, Ricky Hayes. Let's get back into it. So what is the best time to set up DPA ads now that we've connected it and it's running? Okay, so I don't set up DPA ads at least until I generally get one to two sales a day on a store. Okay, or you're earning $30 a day on ads, okay? And the reason you wanna do that is even if you're not getting sales, a DPA ad can get you a sale or two a day that can mean that you're not losing as much money from your cold traffic testing. What are the settings for the DPA ad? I'm gonna show you how to do this. So when you first start, you wanna do 180-day view content minus 180-day purchase. Set it to worldwide, 18 plus men and women, automatic placements, one day click on a $5 budget. So let's find out how to do it. So now we're gonna make the DPA campaign. So to do that, we click create. Just type in DPA remarketing. We wanna choose catalog sales and we choose our catalog. So I've just bound all three, it doesn't matter. It's for the test. And then we wanna give it an ad set name. So I just go broad DPA remarketing, and you want to also, you'll have to make a new ad set as well, but we can do that later on. So we're going to go save draft. All right, and that will show up, ignore that. You want to then go and click into it and go into the ad set, because we're now going to set up the actual settings for this. Okay, so we want to set at $5 budget. You can see how you want it set to all products so that you're choosing your entire catalog, especially at the beginning. You want to change this. So I said 180 day VC minus 180 day purchase. So make sure that you choose that option because we want to get all the traffic possible. You want to set it for the next business day or next day, sorry, in your ad account time zone as well. As a little tip and hack, make sure that you set it to worldwide at the start. If you don't change this, it's only going to go to your home country and most of the time you're not going to be marketing there. Okay, so change to everyone in this location, change nothing else, leave that broad, leave gender open. We don't change anything there. We leave automatic placement on and we just change it to conversion, one day click. All right, and that is how we now set up a DPA ad. So what ad copy do I choose for DPA ads? Okay, I get that question asked a lot. So when we do this, we want to make it interesting and engaging to get them to come back. And I'm going to show you how to do this in a moment. But I just use basic copy because it's a DPA ad. We want to keep the wording broad because we're not targeting for a specific product. We're targeting for everything on our actual store. Okay, so I put the words, "Hi there, we see you're interested in our collection of items or products, but didn't complete your purchase. We're sorry to see you go. Return now and claim 10% off using discount code MY10. Code expires in 24 hours or until stock runs out." Just be a little bit creative, okay? All right, so let's make the actual ad set itself. So we go into the ad set now. We just go edit, let it load. All right, and you can see how it does most of the work for us. All we have to do is update the text, okay? And you can be a little bit creative with what you want there, update the text. And I also, as a little hack, recommend changing this to 10% discount code MY10. Because a lot of people don't read the description, they'll just see the image, and if they see the discount code underneath the product name, it's really important to have that. So they associate with it, that'll help with your conversions on that DPA ad, okay? And that's all you need to do. Just make sure you have it as the Shop Now button, which it should be by default for a DPA ad, and let it roll. Hey everyone, that concludes today's tutorial on Facebook DPA ads in 2019. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment down below. Crush it to go in the competition to win one of two coaching calls in my next video announced, okay? And I'll contact you personally, and we're gonna absolutely love it, okay? Thank you so much for your time.